I see a gallery as a place where anything can happen. The regular rules of society don't apply. Chris Burden had himself shot in the gallery in 1971. Vito Acconci had a piece called Seedbed that involved him masturbating under a temporary gallery floor. Seeing nude people and clothed people interact is one of the more mild things that can happen in a gallery space. The name of this painting is Where the Action Is, and then in quotes and in parentheses, Stag. Stag is in quotes because it's the title of the performance piece happening within the work involving the two male figures. My work process is very slow, very time intensive. After the composition is drafted in pencil, there are three distinct layers of oil paint that go on the canvas. This painting has been exhibited in Basel, at Art Bodensee in Austria, and most recently in New York City. The gallery space in my work features a fictional body of work, and many of these are like a slide reel of Western art history highlights. The gallery space is a forum in which history repeats itself, both intentionally and unintentionally. The works within the works are developed separately before appearing in a composition. For example, the charcoal sketch Simulacrum Study Three Shades becomes the basis for the oil painting Three Shades, which is depicting a fictional performance piece. History is simulated and recreated in the work on the gallery walls, and is additionally reenacted in the gallery space. In Where the Action Is, Stag, the nude male figures are part of a fictional performance piece called Stag. This is taken from a George Bellows composition called Stag at Sharkey's. The Bellows work, in turn, comes from a long line of wrestlers, Olympians, gladiators throughout art history. In my work, the performers are being exploited for the amusement of the spectators. To add insult to injury, the spectators are barely paying attention. Voyeurism, exploitation, and exhibitionism aren't limited to the art world, obviously. They're cornerstones of American culture.